See, here's my thing, right? I grew up down south, I'm a country boy for real, but I've never been hunting before, till last year, right? Because I love animals, right? I'm an animal lover. I think they're beautiful creatures, especially deer. My God, they're so majestic, and they leap, and they eat, and they don't have any top teeth, and I think that's awesome. Here's the problem, though. As a comedian, I drive around the country, right? I've hit four of them fuckers in the last 3 years. So now I want to be a deer hunter, right? I like to kill all of them that I can. I get excited when I think about it. Man, you going to poop or pee? Which one? Okay, good. All right, go ahead. Seriously, well, wait. You go ahead. No, that's cool. It's like 3:45 in the morning, right? I'm dragging ass waiting for my buddy to show up. My buddy rolls up to the deer field in a camouflage pickup truck. Because he don't know that deer don't know that trees don't have wheels. Or listen to Lynyrd Skynyrd at 4 in the morning, whatever, right? And then elephants, you know. Just for me. So anyway, we get to the deer field, right? And my buddy jumps out of his camouflage pickup truck and he runs over and starts squirting me down with something. What's in the bottle, deer hunter?
No urine.
Yeah, deer piss. I took a deer pee golden shower at 4 in the morning with my buddy. I'm like, dude, that is nasty. What is wrong with you? He's like, no, man, the deer love this smell. I'm like, apparently they like the smell of my Chevy bumper. Why don't you go rub your ass on it? So then we get up in the deer stand, right? And we're sitting there, and it is so boring, right? Unless you're just there to see nature, which I could care less about. I just want to kill something at this point, right? We're sitting in the deer stand. It's dark. You can't see nothing. About 6:05, the sun starts coming up. Still nothing going on. I'm bored to death, right? 6:35-ish, a big old buck comes up walking over the horizon. I mean, he was a big, well, he had four. He was a big buck, right? And I got excited. I got excited, man. I took that rifle and I put that scope right on that deer's heart. And I was gonna do it. I was gonna shoot him. And I started shaking. I got scared, right? And I took that scope and I looked up into those big, beautiful brown eyes and I started thinking, I can't do it, I can't do it. Because he was too close to shoot with a rifle. I got a bow and arrow and I nailed his ass. But I didn't kill it though. Because on the end of my arrows, I put a suction cup. It's way more fun. Deer's just out there eating.
You son of a bitch!
deer got so mad he flipped me off. He was like, "Marr!" See, it's a hoof. They don't have fingers. Let's take an elephant break. You guys at this table, you got any youngins? Little kids? How many you got right there? You got three youngins. How old are they?
19, 18, and 12.
Okay, so they're older kids. That's cool. Good for you. That means you're almost out of the woods, right? But here's the thing. 19, 18, and 12, that 12-year-old, you're stuck with for a bit. But that 19 and 18-year-old, you can get ready to give them the boot. And it's cool because them sons of bitches will come right back. That's what kids do now. They just, they call them rebounders. They'll come back. But help them out, you know what I mean? Like, I have two kids myself. And my one son, who I love to death, he likes to partake of the devil's lettuce. I don't know if y'all know what that is. This side of the room, I'm sure, does. It's... He likes to smoke a little, you know what I mean? Get all goofy. You never knew he smoked until he runs out, and you're like, "Damn, get some, dude, you're driving me crazy." He has ADD. Y'all know what ADD is?
Yeah.
I have to ask, because I did a show down in Alabama. I was like, "My son has ADD." And the lady in the front row stood up and went, "You are a moron. That is ADT. It is an alarm company." Which is kind of cool. Think about it, like if the alarm company hired people that had ADD. Hurry up, get here, my house is getting broken into. Okay, calm down, ma'am. I'm going to need your PIN code, your address, and I got a big blue bike. It is awesome. I love my son to death. He's a spitting image of me, kind of goofy, you know what I mean? He did this thing not too long ago when he turned 15 or whatever. We bought him a pickup truck and we fixed it up a little bit. And he was getting ready to turn 16. And I got ready to go on the road. I said, "Just leave that truck alone. I'll take care of it when I get back." He said, "Okay." So apparently, if you have ADD in your mind, that is, wait till that son of a bitch pulls out of the parking lot. I'm taking this thing for a ride, right? So I was about 2 hours away. And he was driving a pickup truck, and I get a phone call. "You got to get back here right away." I was like, "Why?" He's like, "Well, Cody was in an accident." I'm like, "Oh, I'm going to kill him." They're like, "No, Dane, this is serious. You got to get here." So I drive back, and I get over to St. Louis over in the hospital. My son's all hooked up to machines and stuff, you know. He's like, got that morphine-induced haze or whatever. I walk in the room, and I'm like, "Oh, I'm like, Cody, I'm here, buddy. Are you going to be okay?" And my son looks up at me through his drug-induced coma thing, and he goes, "Dad, I think my guardian angel's got ADD too." And I tell that story, right, because I believe this in my life. Whatever it is, if you can learn to laugh at it, you can get through it. It doesn't matter what it is. If you can learn to laugh at it in its face, you can get through it. And I got one more serious story, and then I'm going to tell you something else, and I'm going to get out of here. But my wife, who I love to death, came to me about a year ago, and she said, "Dean, I got a bump in my belly." I'm like, "What are you talking about?" She said, "No, I got a bump right here. You got to feel it." And I reached down and I felt it. And there was a bump there. I was like, "Holy cow, did you poop this week?" She's like, "This is serious, idiot." I'm like, "Okay, well, what can we do?" She's like, "Well, we need to go to the doctor." We went to the doctor and they did one of them CAT scan thingies where they look at, you know, different sections or whatever. And they found a mass on our ovaries. And it scared me to death, right? I was like, "Holy cow, you know, this is real life. I got to figure this one out." And I'm still looking for a way that I can make her smile and laugh, because I know if I can, she's going to get through it. I can't think of nothing. A couple days go by, the oncologist comes in and they say it's cancer. She has an ovarian cyst and it has turned into ovarian cancer. And they're going to have to take it out. And the doctor said it's 7 inches wide by 5 inches deep. It's growing really fast. And we're terrified, right? So the doctor says, "Well, listen, we're going to take it out by something called cesarean section." And I said, "What the hell is that?" Because I didn't know. And the doctor said, "Well, that's kind of like what they do when you're having a baby. So this would be like you guys are having a baby." And without thinking, I went, "Great, we'll name it Lumpy." Right? Open mouth, insert foot, you know what I mean? I'm like, "Wow, you insensitive jerk, what are you doing?" And my wife, who's been with me for so long, 7+ years now, looked me in the eye and went, "Well, you can tell from that CAT scan that some bitch looks just like you. You can't deny it." And that's when I knew we were going to be okay. So the doctors went in there and they pulled it out of there and did something with it, took a bunch of tests on it. Sure enough, it was cancer. And then it was you know, chemo and everything, and her hair fell out. So when her hair fell out, I shaved my head. And the weird thing about it is hers is starting to grow back now. I got this fucking spot right here that won't for no reason. But believe me when I tell you that she's back here tonight, and I just want to give her a quick round of applause. Honey, I love you. You're a survivor, a fighter. God bless you, girl.